With this video, I want to show you how to go from slide number 1 to slide number 2 with a custom transitions like that. You can repeat and copy this over to other slide as long as you have one color background. Alright, how to go about this? Actually, we have 3 animated boxes which fly into the slide and create this transition. Let me delete them to show you exactly how to do something like this. At first, you want to go to Insert, Shapes, and you want to insert a rectangle shape. Take this rectangle and make it to the size of the slide. Okay, perfect. Now you want to put it perfectly above the slide. If you are not certain if this is perfectly above the slide, you can right-click, Format Shape, and in the Format Shape on the right side you have Size and Properties. In the Size and Properties, you have Position. Just make sure that it is 0 and negative 7.5. This makes sure that a rectangle of the size of the slide is perfectly above it. Once you have this step ready, you can go straight into Animations, open the animations, and give this object a line animation. Let me close the format background and open the animation pane. This animation pane shows now that we have one animation on the text, but this is irrelevant. But the blue animation is a motion path animation. And you want to take this red object of this motion path and you want to put it here on the slide, exactly, so it covers up the entire screen. Right now, you can maybe reduce the duration to 1 second. It depends on what kind of motion you want, and you can right click and get Start with Previous. I'll move it a bit forward and let me preview this animation. If you will preview this animation, you can see this object flies perfectly into the slide. You can notice a blue line here. You can get, of course, rid of that by clicking on this object, Shape Format, Shape Outline, and make No Outline. Currently, we have this beautiful animation of this object falling onto our screen, but we are not quite there yet. But we are very close. Click on this object, double-click on this animation, and on the effect options, make sure that you reduce the smooth start and increase the smooth end. This will make sure that the animation will have a slower ending, and this is like perfectly what you want from a transition to the next slide, because you want the next slide to be like slowly introduced and then the animations move forward. To continue with our transition, you have to decide how many of those boxes you want to fly down from the sky. In my opinion, like 2, 3, or 4 is the optimal amount. Let's go for 3. You will just click on this object, Ctrl D, move it somewhere else, Ctrl D, move it somewhere else, so you perfectly see the difference in the colors. You need to make sure that the object most in front of you is the same color as the background on the next slide. If the next slide would be white, so this last one should be white as well. This will make for a seamless transition. Let me select the last, the most in the background one, Shape Format, Shape Fill, Eyedropper, and I have here colors prepared, so I'll just use them. Go ahead for the next, Eyedropper, maybe this orange. And for the very last one, I want the color from the next slide. To make sure, I'll just go Shape Fill, Eyedropper, and I select the color directly from the slide. In the animation pane, I want to click on each of them and I want delay this animation so they do not happen at once. I want a small delay between all of them, so I am staggering them. Alright, now I can preview the animation on this entire slide. 1, 2, 3. Okay, perfectly. Everything flies in seamless. You can now take your skills and position it perfectly, or, as I shown you previously, you can just right-click, Format Shape. Depending on which way you prefer, you can go to the sizing options and the position option and just click here 0, negative 7.5, negative 7.5, enter, and you are sure that everything is perfectly aligned. You are basically done with this transition. And what's also great, you can just take those 3 animations, Ctrl C, I have them already here, but I would delete them, and Ctrl V them onto any slide you'd like. What you need to make sure is go to transitions and make sure you do not have on mouse click selected, but after 0 seconds. After 0 seconds tells PowerPoint that the slide needs to proceed to the next slide once all animations are done. In my case, this is exactly the place when I want this slide to proceed to the next slide. If you need more time to like elaborate on your slide, no problem. Move those animations a bit forward to the place you want. You can even move them, of course, 20 seconds. It depends on what you have to say. But for the sake of the video, I want, of course, short durations between the slide. This is slide number 2. Let's transition. This is slide number 3. Let's transition to the end. Boom, boom, boom. Beautiful. And my presentation is ending. I hope you've learned a lot about positioning and animating, and this will be worth to remember. Thank you, and see you in other videos like this.